Habaragani. What's the word? And the word on the fourth day of Kwanzaa is the principle of Ujamaa, which means cooperative economics, to build and maintain our own stores, shops, and businesses, and to profit from them together. Our presenter, Reverend Odell Cleveland, founded America's first faith-based community action agency, the Welfare Reform Liaison Project, 2 decades ago in Greensboro. What started out in a side annex of Mount Zion Baptist Church, where Odell now serves as chief administrative officer, grew into a $100 million nonprofit organization with an outsized impact on North Carolina's most marginalized. He co-authored the book, Pracademics and Community Change, a true story of nonprofit development and social entrepreneurship. During welfare reform, Reverend Odell Cleveland will share the knowledge and wisdom obtained as he continues to apply the principle of Ujamaa to his life's work of community problem solving and service to humanity. The International Civil Rights Center and Museum is proud to present Reverend Odell Cleveland. Ujamaa.
The fourth Kwanzaa principles, Ujamaa, corporate economics. Ujamaa corporate economics literally means familyhood. Also stresses self-reliance in building, strengthening, and controlling of the economics in our own community. It is essentially a commitment to the practice of shared social wealth and the work necessary to achieve it. Quite often, people ask the question, how do we achieve it? How do we go about doing it? How do you make this work? When you start talking about shared wealth, when you start talking about shared cooperation around economics, the answer I always give them is this example. When my son went to college, and he asked the question, Daddy, what do you want me to bring back to the family? Because remember, this is about family. This is about community. This is about a peoplehood. And I said, Calvin, we know this family knows how to work hard to earn money, but I need you to go to school, son, to learn how money can work for the family. And that's the essence of this principle, is the fact that we have to do for self when it comes to economics. Many has been very controversial about the fact that, is this socialism or is this capitalism? And we get argued and caught up in the weeds of what it is and what it's not. But the principle says that we work together, and gaining wealth is not a bad thing, but gaining wealth just to gain wealth is not the answer. Gaining wealth to help so many people make a difference. A hand up, I would suggest, versus a hand out. But at the same time, how do our community get better? How does our community get healthier? How does one family get healthier? How does one family get better? And that's working together as a unit. And the principle here is the fact that when we start investing in ourselves, we teach the principles like financial literacy, teaching, understanding, generation to generation on how money is a tool, T-O-O-L, and not a toy. And this principle has been demonstrated to us over the years. When our ancestors were enslaved, they demonstrated this whole principle of economic independence. Even when one was under the bondage of slavery, in the cities, in the streets of Charleston, South Carolina, folk would be hired out as enslaved African Americans. And then they would go out and they would work for others and bring their masters back a certain percentage of their wages. But the other percentages that they earned above and beyond of what that was expected, they would take that and invest in themselves. But not just financial investment, the investment of knowledge, skill set, understanding, so that when we teach each other, we understand that the skills, the understanding, the literacy is passed down. So when you deal with situations like heirs' property that came from a lot of enslaved ancestors and it was passed down from generation to generation, you understand that the property that was obtained during Jim Crow and other eras, those are tools. You don't sell your homestead, you invest. And when you have a family member or you have a member in the community or you have someone who you can touch who don't understand it the way you understand it, you don't look down on them. You help them up. And back to our principle, corporate economics. We're not competing against ourselves. We're working together to help. One of the other main principles here is the whole idea of strategy. How do we handle that what we had? Our ancestors took little of nothing and made a lot of that. They built schools, they built faith communities, they built businesses, they were entrepreneurs. In the agrarian South, when land and property was the value associated with it, they were able to go and do their own sharecropping. Yes, they didn't always get the best when it came to the splits and what they owned, but also the other side of it, of slavery, was this. When you were able to get what they called as a slave badge, let me explain. For many people, they see slavery as going with the wind on the plantation, picking cotton. But the other side was the skill set, where you hired yourself out. But to do that in a city like Charleston, South Carolina, you had to obtain a slave badge. We would say similar to a dog tag or even a work permit. And when you had that badge, you can go and earn as much as you had the opportunity to earn. And that's where a lot of the freedom came from, because one must be free economically in one's mind before one free economically physically. So when our ancestors, when they made the raw iron into gates, when they sell the fruits and vegetables in the market, they understood what they were doing. And they understood that they could pool their money together and help others escape the freedom, help others corner the market and fresh fruits and vegetables, help others to the point that the whites in Charleston, South Carolina got so upset with the fact that the black people, even enslaved black Africans, had so much economic power till they went and changed the laws about what a free black man and an enslaved black man could do. So we know this principle works, but the other side of the principle is we have to always look out for those who are not as fortunate as others. And that whole principle, when you start dealing with it, and let me read it. It states, to build and maintain our stores, shops, and other businesses, and to profit from them together. A lot of times when we celebrate Kwanzaa, we think of the whole idea of how does one profit and share together? And that's where we have to sidestep the concept of socialism that a lot of people try to derail this concept with. When I give my fellow man a hand up, when I teach him what I know, when I share my resources with him, that's not giving away what I have, that's investing in him. And once we invest in him or her, then the money comes back financially to the family, because when we all do well, everyone does better, not just one individual. And for those who don't quite get it, we have to be in a position to continue to give back. And that's the essence. Our ancestor gave back. Was it in the form of food? They gave back to those who didn't have. Was it in the form of resources? They gave back. And this whole principle of social economics and the whole principle of cooperative economics is about giving back. Chioma is based on the assumption of human equality, on the belief that it's wrong for one person to dominate or exploit another, and on the knowledge that every individual hopes to live in a society as a free person, able to lead a decent life in conditions of peace with his or her neighbor. Chioma rejects the idea of wealth for wealth's sake, as opposed to wealth for the well-being for all, and a commitment to the belief that there are more important things in life than the amassing of riches, and that if the pursuit of wealth clashes with things like human dignity and social equality, then the latter will be given priority. In the context of improving and ensuring the well-being of the people, the creation of wealth is a good thing and something we shall have to increase. However, he concludes, it will cease to be good the moment that wealth ceases to serve humans and begins to be served by humans. I think we all understand money is not the root of all evil, but if we don't use money the right way, it can be evil. At one time, as a people, enslaved, my ancestors worked together with what little they had. They spoke Geechee Gullah language. They spoke in code so that their enslavers didn't understand what they were doing. And the whole institution of slavery trying to divide my ancestors came together in spite of and because of what they did and didn't have. Ujamaa also stresses self-reliance in building, strengthening, and controlling of the economics of our own community. Self-reliance, first and foremost, that for our development, we have to depend upon ourselves and our own resources. The assumption here is that we must seize and maintain the initiative in all that is ours, and that we must harness our resources and put them to the best possible use in the service of the community. That is not to say denying the assistance from work of others, but of controlling policies, shouldering the essential responsibilities of our own future. We are responsible for ourselves. Quite often, many say it's the white man who holds us back. Yes and no. A lot of times, it's one's own thought on what he or she can do which holds us back. And as we continue to practice this principle of the whole idea of corporate economics, we understand the power that's in it. And in closing, the obligation, the generosity for the poor and for the vulnerable. Many of the Holy Scriptures talk about taking care of the least of these, how we have to look out for those who can't take care of themselves. We've always been a people who took care of each other. We've always been, from our ancestors to now, caring, looking back, sharing what we have with others, in spite of what they may do to us. As leaders of our families, as leaders of our community, economics makes all the difference in the world. And as we look back, we light the fourth candle of Kwanzaa, Ujamaa, and that candle, corporate economics, make all the difference in the world. Thank you.